Is your emergency fund enough? Hello, and welcome to Fit Finance, where we talk all about finance and career. Watch the rest of this video to see the best places to hold your emergency fund. So what is an emergency fund? An emergency fund, often known as a rainy day fund, can help you get through difficult financial times. The pandemic has brought to light the need of having some cash on hand. However, how can you know when you've had your fill? HSBC conducted a survey to encourage financial wellness among its clients and discovered that 80% of those polled had an emergency fund. While this is fantastic news, it still leaves the question of how much is enough unanswered. The 3-month rule of thumb. You've probably heard of the 3-month rule when it comes to putting money aside for an emergency. Having an emergency fund large enough to cover 3 months worth of living expenditures is what this entails. For those whose income isn't steady, such as commission earners, seasonal laborers, and the self-employed, some experts recommend 6 months. So, if your monthly living expenditures are $1,000, you should have at least $3,000 in the bank. For individuals who aren't salaried, the amount rises to $6,000. But is it possible for you to put additional money into your emergency fund? Let's face it, in these difficult economic times, having a larger safety net makes sense. 3 months flies past, especially if you're on furlough. The unemployment rates increased in 2020, forcing many people to tap into their savings. Events like these also raise the question of whether a 3-month emergency fund is adequate, given how difficult it is to return to work after a pandemic. Increasing your emergency funds as much as possible might help alleviate some of the stress of being laid off. However, it's crucial to keep in mind that putting too much money in a standard savings account can backfire. Even if you have the best savings account at the best bank, it will not offer you a better interest rate than inflation. You'll be lucky if you earn a 1% return on your investments, and inflation is now more than twice that. It's worth shopping around for rates that teeter closer to the 2% or 3% mark. But accounts offering these rates might limit access to your funds. Should you invest your emergency fund? While some investments, such as government bonds, are perceived to be less dangerous than others, all investments include risk. Emergency money should be provided right away, and the capital should be safeguarded. There are a variety of products that may be suited, and you may want to explore combining them to gain more space. Put half in a current or savings account, a quarter in premium bonds, and the rest in a notice deposit account, for example. So where are the best places to put your emergency savings? You need to be able to sleep at night knowing that your emergency fund is protected. Thus, safety is essential. Accessibility is also crucial, because you may need the money in your emergency fund at any time. You'll want to be able to withdraw funds quickly and without incurring any fees. Here are a few excellent choices. Money market deposit account or online savings account. Although both accounts have distinct names, they are equally suitable for your emergency fund. These accounts offer the most competitive interest rates on savings products. In addition to insurance coverage from the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation or the National Credit Union Association. These also have a guardrail that prevents you from thinking about spending from them in regular non-pandemic times, a monthly withdrawal limit of 6. One thing to keep in mind, transfers from an online savings account can take up to 2 days, whereas transfers from your primary bank savings account can happen right away. You can elect to keep a modest amount of money at your regular bank for quick access, while keeping the majority of your emergency savings in the internet account, bank, or credit union savings account. You could also consider opening a second savings account with your primary bank. This streamlines your financial life by consolidating everything into one place and separating your emergency fund from the one you use for day-to-day expenses. Transfers from your primary bank can also happen instantly. You may, however, forego the opportunity to earn interest. When compared to low-overhead, online-only banks, institutions with large networks of brick-and-mortar locations give a pittance of yield. Money market mutual fund. These accounts offer yet another safe haven for emergency finances. They are low-risk and conveniently accessible parking spots for pay, albeit they do not come with insurance cover. The interest earnings, on the other hand, aren't really impressive. A fundamental distinction between these and money market accounts. The worst places to put your emergency savings. Knowing where to put your money and where not to keep it is an equally vital lesson. These locations can be beneficial for your other financial needs, but they are not built for emergency storage. Checking account. When you combine your emergency savings with your regular checking account, you run the risk of making your emergency savings too accessible. It's preferable to keep these two fully separate. Otherwise, you run the danger of depleting your emergency fund and promising to replenish it when your next paycheck arrives, and the potential to break that promise. Another significant disadvantage is the lack of earning possibilities. Standard checking accounts pay nominal interest rates, and in certain situations, pay no interest at all. Certificate of deposit. Any early withdrawal of funds from a standard CD is subject to a penalty. So if you put your emergency savings in a 1-year CD and then need the money in 4 months, you'll lose interest and may even have to pay extra money to get it. Alternative no penalty CDs are available. However, some of them still have access restrictions. The stock exchange. The stock market, with an average yearly return of 10%, is ideal for long-term investors. When you have the chance to play a very short game, for example, if you need your money next week, avoid the market at all costs. Consider the 4-day period in March 2020 when the Dow Jones Industrial Average fell by 26%. Savings bonds. A portion of your emergency money could be saved in savings bonds. However, there are a number of disadvantages to employing them as a safety cushion. You can't cash in a savings bond for a year after purchasing it. While these do pay interest, if you cash in the bond within 5 years of purchase, you will lose 3 months of your earnings. At home. If you're thinking about putting your emergency cash under your mattress or in a safe at home, you should reconsider. In the event of a house catastrophe, such as a fire or theft, you'll find yourself in another severe situation. Your money will be gone, with no method of getting it back. Well, that's it for this video. Give it a thumbs up and share this video to a friend that might need an emergency fund. Don't forget to subscribe to Fit Finance for your weekly finance and career tips.